game in the closet, Jake. Okay? We need to work underneath a little bit. He's setting the pace. You're not setting the pace. Listen to me. You're headhunting a little bit too much. Anytime you throw something, you need to come back underneath because he's dropping down. You got to follow my instructions. Watch your range. If you double jab, don't get too close. Immediately go underneath, underneath, underneath. Then you can come back over the top. You're headhunting a little bit too much. Okay? It looks like it's a dead end fight.
He sees Jermaine rushing in. Both fighters trying to throw combinations at the same time, and that's what caused the accidental hit. But you knew it was coming sooner or later because both guys were trying so hard to get to one another without being caught in the process.
Copy box numbers in the fifth round. Hopkins 7 out of only 20, but they were all 7 power connects, and some of them were good, solid shots, including the two big right hands. Taylor 8 out of 38. He's still throwing more punches and landing more as the fight progresses.
This is more of an interesting fight than a
war.
Thrilling fight because of the stakes that are so high, because of the contrast in the fighters.
And because Bernard Hopkins, as Roy Jones pointed out, doesn't care about entertainment value.
Not at all.
Wants to fight at the pace that favors him.
And he has given him a little entertainment tonight already, but he's slowly finding his rhythm, finding his punching pace, finding his range, and it could mean big trouble for Jermaine Taylor.
Yeah, but we're within 2 minutes of the midway point of the fight, and Taylor's still in it, and still doing basically what he did in round one.
Well, I can guarantee you Hopkins did not plan to win the first half of the fight.
I'm sure. You're right.
Stop.
Now box. The blood continues to flow from the cut on top of Jermaine Taylor's head because of the placement of that cut on top of the skull, Roy. I'm not sure they'll be able to stop that bleeding.
I don't think they will either. The other thing is that they all talked about Jermaine Taylor's jab, but now his jab has been taken away from him pretty much by Hopkins, and he seems to be a little confused right now.
I agree. He doesn't seem to know exactly what he wants to do offensively because he's not able to set the tempo as easily as he did against every other professional opponent with the jab.
And that's the thing that worried me about it, because I knew he wouldn't beat Bernard Hopkins with the jab.
Going to have to find another way to do it.
Exactly. And it's got to be work. You're 26 and you fight a 40-year-old guy, you got to try to outwork him. Especially when he's as good a veteran as Bernard Hopkins is.
So should he be throwing more punches?
Yes, he should stay on the attack. He should never let Bernard sit in his rhythm, because this is when Bernard is waiting to set him up with something. That's what he should be doing right there.
Well, he did exactly what trainer Pat Burns told him, working underneath and going to the body.
So what happened, he stood there, he got caught with a flush right hand, and every time Bernard catches him sitting still waiting, he's going to hit him with that shot. Can't wait on the veteran. You gotta rush the veteran.
Bell, stop, please.
A high action round, though, for Taylor. The body punches probably won in the round because he was so much more active than Hopkins.
Outside right. That's all, baby. Outside right. Outside right, son. Can't hit what you can't see.
All right. Okay. Stop putting that cold water on him. You need to be impressive.
Yes, sir.
You had a nice flurry over here when you threw 4 or 5 punch combinations. You're getting him against the rope. Shoot high, you know he's going to drop. 4 or 5 punches. It's more of a smart fight. Just throw some shots to the body. Come back up, okay? Mm-hmm. That's how you steal these rounds. And you do some damage to the body. All right? Mm-hmm. You're shooting those jabs and he's dropping. And then you're not putting any
more. He see Hopkins in a beautiful counter hook right there. Or actually the counter jab. Right when he said Jermaine Taylor does the bow and arrow with his right hand, he jabs with his jab, and he pulls his right hand back, and he stepped inside that jab and countered with a beautiful jab.
Combi box numbers in 6. Taylor's best round, 17 out of 45. Bernard Hopkins threw 17 punches. He's only averaging 18 punches per round thrown in the first half of the bout. Harold, how do you have it through 6?
You know, Jim, I tell you something. I can't see how you can win a fight by standing straight up and making funny faces at your opponent. And that's all Bernard Hopkins is doing. I mean, Jermaine Taylor's carrying his fight to him. He's more aggressive. He's getting off first, just like you saw there. He's landing the hardest shots, just like you saw there. I mean, 5-1, Jermaine Taylor, 59-55. He's winning it easy.
I have it 4-1 with one even.
Roy Jones, if the scores are something like 5-1, does that do anything to Dent Hopkins' confidence?
Nope, not at all. That's what he used to. I mean, he's used to fighting against all odds. Trust me, he's not trying to win the early part of this fight. That's what he wants to do right there.
He landed a sensational right-hand counterpunch right on the jaw of Taylor, the biggest punch of the fight so far. But remains right there.
As long as he can do that, he won't be deafened at all.
Hopkins missed with the right hand that time, and Taylor got him with a left uppercut to the body. Double jab by Taylor.
Hopkins just did miss him with another beautiful right hand.
Stop. No, no anymore. Sit, relax now. Sit back. No.
Yeah, but you know, boy, Hopkins is not a big hitter. He's never been a big puncher. He's always worn down his opponents by attrition.
And that's why I think that's what I think he's trying to do here.
But he's not active enough to do it, it seems to me.
The pro-Taylor crowd booing as Hopkins is again warned, this time for holding inside. Jay Nady has not deducted a point from anybody so far. Bernard Hopkins, it would appear, if the fight's going to go to the scorecards, can ill afford to lose a point deduction.
I mean, if Hopkins is trying to pop shoot him 2 or 3 times around, Roy, that's not enough.
No, it's not. He's just hoping to wear the kid down first, then hit him with a good shot.
Then you're saying he's trying to not, he's hoping to knock him out?
Yes, that's what he's hoping to do. He's not looking at trying to outbox this young kid. He'd be crazy to do that. So his thing is to wear him down, keep touching him every now and then, get him a little tired, then he's hoping when he touch him, he can help.
You can't count on getting a young fighter tired.
Really interesting.
I think.
The popular media choice was Hopkins by decision. And there's another look at Lou DiBella. So far, no look of great confidence or celebration on DiBella's face as he waits and watches and hopes in what is something of a holy grail for him.
Sunday, and you're doing it with him. Make his ass fight. Do you understand? Just throwing punches, working the body. Just throwing some punches in there. You need to throw at least 25 jabs around. You're throwing 10 punches around. You're not
kicking, right? Just pick up a little bit of a little more jab. That's all. Stay outside. You don't fight me inside. You fight me outside.
I'm looking for that uppercut.
You're smarter than me. You're smarter than I am. So you fight me outside.
Roy, it sounds like Bowie Fischer, Hopkins' trainer, is seeing a different fight than we are. I mean, he seems to think that everything's going along great.
Pat Burns must be too, because he's fussing at Jermaine Taylor about not being busy enough.
Well, I think Burns is probably right that Taylor enhances his chance to win if he can be busier. On the other hand, CompuBox numbers show Taylor throwing exactly twice as many punches per round, getting off 37 punches per round to, so far, only 18 for Hopkins. And again, those of us who wonder how Bernard Hopkins is going to win this fight don't see him getting that much more active. It's about selection, obviously. And you're saying, Roy, that withering right-hand counter and the left hook, thrown effectively, will eventually reel the young fighter in.
Well, that's what he's trying to do, I think. I think his plan was not try to come in and outwork the guy, but try to come out, take him in the deep water, and then catch him with a big shot. That's what I think his plan is, because he didn't come out aggressive. He didn't come out and throw a lot of punches to show that he wanted to outwork Jermaine Taylor, so that has to be his plan. Now, I don't know if that's going to work.
My feeling is it better be, because if the plan involved winning rounds, he's not doing that.
That's what I'm trying to say.
And now Taylor willing to exchange, and Hopkins begins to throw a little more, and they're even in that exchange. jab from Hopkins, pretty rare so far.